Okay, good morning everyone. All of you are here. Can we start?
Just 33.
Okay, tumalokor agote physics or class loisilo na nai moi etu sectionat.
Nai hoa ma'am.
Introductory class to hoa nai.
Nai hoa.
Acha, thik ache baro tumalokor first or class. এতিয়া এটেন্ডেন্স দিব নালাগে হ্যাঁ যেতিয়া কম তেতিয়া দিবা নো নিড টু পুট ইয়োর অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স রাইট নাও
ওকে
আই উইল আস্ক ওকে সো উই উইল স্টার্ট আওয়ার ফিজিক্স ক্লাসেস ফ্রম দা ইউনিট প্রপার্টিজ অফ ফ্লুইড ওকে Okay, so our first unit will be from my part, properties of fluid. So we already know that the fluids are the substances which has the tendency to flow. So the contents of this unit is introduction to fluid, fluid properties, fluid pressure, Pascal's law, atmospheric pressure, and then specific density and specific gravity. So I already told you that fluids are the substances which have tendency to flow. All the liquids and gases are fluids. Again, we know that fluids do not have any fixed shape. So fluids is defined as a substance which is capable to flow from one point to another. Fluid can change its shape whenever an external force is applied on it. In steady state, if we apply an external force, then the shape of the fluid will change. It take the shape of the container in which it is contained. Again, if we apply an external force, then with a very minimum force actually, then the shape of the fluid will change. So the actually this chapter is from fluid mechanics, actually a chapter from fluid mechanics. So fluid mechanics is the branch of science which deals with the behavior of fluids. So all liquids and gases are fluids. Can anyone tell me what is the difference between liquid and gases? What is the difference between liquid and gases? Can anyone tell me? See, liquid and gases both are fluids, but what is the difference between them? You already know that. I think in your class 9 you have this chapter.
Liquid is boiling point and gas is
what? What?
Liquid is boiling point.
Liquid is boiling point. How?
Ma'am, gas don't have.
Liquid has boiling point, but liquid is not boiling point. Liquid has a boiling point, yes, but liquid is not boiling point. Yes, someone else.
Gas don't have a definite volume.
Yes, yes, yes.
Or shape.
Gas don't have definite volume and shape, and liquids. They have definite shape. No.
Definite volume.
Yes, they have definite volume, but don't have definite shape. Liquids have a definite volume, but they don't have any definite shape. But the gases don't have a definite volume and shape. Okay. So, what are the states of matter? All of you know now the states of matter. What are those?
Solid, liquid, and gas.
Can anyone
solid,
tell? Yes,
solid,
yes.
Solid, liquid, and gas.
Yes. Can anyone tell me one some properties of solid? Can anyone tell me any one of the properties of solid?
They have rigid shape and definite volume.
Yes, yes. So liquids and gases are quite similar, but only difference between them is liquids have a definite volume, but gases don't have like a definite volume. So together they both are called fluids because they have the tendency to flow. So if we take a gas in a container and a liquid in a container, then what happens? The gas will take all of the volume of the container, but in case of liquids, they only fill and certain amount of the container, certain part of the container. So this is the difference between liquids and gas. You can write down the difference between liquid and gases, that gases have definite liquids have definite volume, but gases don't have definite volume. Okay, so these are some properties of fluids. Again, here written, fluids do not have any definite shape. Okay, and it can take the shape of the containing vessel. So these are some properties of fluids. You can write down the properties. They are density, viscosity, temperature, pressure, specific volume, specific weight, specific density, and specific gravity. These are the main properties of fluid. So what do you mean by density? So density is the, does anyone know what is density?
Mass per volume of the object.
Mass per volume of the object, yes. So student, if you don't have to ask anything, then please keep your microphones on mute. Only turn on your microphone if you have to ask me something. Okay, density is the mass per volume of a fluid, or we can say the ratio of mass and volume of a fluid. So what will be the unit of density? See, the unit of mass is kg and unit of volume is meter cube. So what will be the unit of density? Kg per meter cube. Okay, so with the increase of temperature, density will increase or decrease? Does anyone know? With the increase of temperature, density will increase or decrease? Can anyone tell me? Amina, after, please keep your microphone in mute. তোমালোকে কিয় মাইক্রোফোন অফ নকৰা কোৱাচোন ইমান কম সব টিচাৰেতো এইটোৱে কয় তোমালোকক মাইক্রোফোন অফ কৰিবৰ কাৰণে ঠিক আছে উইথ দ্য ইনক্রিজ অফ টেম্পারেচার ডেনসিটি উইল ইনক্রিজ অর ডিক্রিজ
decrease.
Decrease. Yes, density will decrease with the increase of temperature, because with the increase of temperature the intermolecular space will increase, and that's why with the increase of temperature the density will decrease. Okay, so next property is viscosity. So what is viscosity? Viscosity is the fluid property that determine the amount of resistance of fluid to the force. Excuse me. Yes, come in. Dada, class to yes. Class to yes. Okay. Viscosity is the fluid property that determine the amount of resistance of the fluid to the to any kind of force. So if a liquid is in steady state, it is in rest, then if you have to flow the liquid, then we have to apply some external force. If we apply the force less than its viscosity, then the liquid will not flow. The liquid will flow only if we apply a force which is more than its viscosity. So viscosity is the fluid property that determine the amount of resistance of the liquid to the applied force. So kiman khini leke liquid to force diyar pichor to resist koribo paribo, hetu hol viscosity. If we apply some force but the liquid is not flowing, it is because we are applying a force which is less than its viscosity. Next property is temperature. Okay, all of you are getting viscosity, na?
Yes,
ma'am. Any question on viscosity? Viscosity sabre bujhi paisa? All of you understand? Understood viscosity?
Mic off karna hai to phone.
Okay. Now the next property is temperature. So temperature is the property that determines the degree of hotness or coldness of the level of heat intensity of the fluid. Means it is the property that determines the degree of hotness or coldness of the fluid, or it determines the level of heat intensity. So temperature is measured by three temperature scales. Does anyone know what are the temperature, what are these temperature scales? Temperatures are measured by using three temperature scales. All of you know that.
Kelvin, Fahrenheit, Celsius.
Yes, Kelvin, Fahrenheit and Celsius. Celsius. Right. What is your name? अभी जिसने आंसर किया उसका नाम क्या है?
जी जी छेत्री मैम.
Okay, good. Okay, next is pressure. Pressure is, we already know about pressure. So pressure of a fluid is the force per unit of the fluid. Force per unit of the fluid. So pressure is always downwards. Always remember that pressure is always downwards. So pressure of the fluid is the force per unit area of the fluid. So we always know that the force per unit area of the fluid is pressure. So the unit of force is Newton, and unit of then what will be the unit of pressure? Pressure is force per unit area. So the unit of area is m squared. So what will be the unit
Pascal
of
pressure?
Yes, Pascal, but we can say
Pascal.
It is yes, but in simple words we can say is Newton per meter square. Right?
Newton per meter square.
Yes. So pressure is denoted by always T. So next property is specific volume. Specific volume is reciprocal of specific reciprocal of density. Okay. So we know that density is mass per volume, right? So what is specific volume? Specific volume is so density is mass per volume. Then specific volume is volume is the volume of the fluid occupied per unit mass. It is the reciprocal of density. So density is P equal to m by v, then specific volume equal to v by m. So specific volume is always denoted by small v, and the unit is meter cube per kg. So volume per mass, right? So the unit of volume is meter cube, and the unit of mass is kg. So unit of specific volume will be meter cube per kg. Now specific weight. Okay. Specific weight is the weight possessed by unit volume of a fluid. It is denoted by small w, and its unit is newton per meter cube. So specific weight is the weight possessed by a unit volume of a fluid. So the weight of unit volume of a fluid is the specific weight. Unit means say unit volume, is 1 meter per kg. So the weight of that 1 meter cube per kg volume will be specific weight of this liquid. So specific weight can vary from place to place because it is depends on gravity, and acceleration due to gravity is different for different places. Therefore specific volume will change in different places. So the specific volume W equal to weight per volume. The unit of it is newton per meter cube. Then next topic is specific gravity. You don't need the specific density for. Specific gravity is the ratio of specific weight of the fluid, given fluid, to the weight of the standard fluid. So the standard fluid is water, and specific standard fluid is not water. So the specific gravity is the ratio of specific weight of the given fluid to the specific weight of the standard fluid. It is denoted by the letter smallest. So specific, since specific gravity is the ratio of two different specific weight, that's why it has no unit. So specific gravity has no unit. You don't need the specific density part. It is okay. Any question up to this? Yes, any question? Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, viscosity part, can you please explain?
Viscosity part. So suppose a pool of water, okay? Or we can it is in rest, right? It is not flowing. It is in rest. So if we have to flow the liquid, or flow the water, we have to apply some external force, right? So if we apply a force which is less than its viscosity, it will not flow. If we apply a force which is greater than its viscosity, only then the liquid will flow. So viscosity is the fluid property that determines the amount of resistance of the fluid to the applied force. Up to कब तक वो रेजिस्टेंस कर सकेगा, कब तक वो रेस्ट पे रहेगा, कि जितना भी हम फोर्स अप्लाई करें कब तक वो रेजिस्ट कर सकेगा. अगर वो रेजिस्ट कर नहीं कर सका दैट मीन्स द फोर्स इज मोर देन इट्स विस्कोसिटी. ओके आप समझ में आया. ओके सो एनीवन एल्स.
मैम स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम टू कैन के मेजर करिम.
स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम टू तो स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम टू अब डेंसिटी उल्टा तो डेंसिटी होल की मास पर वॉल्यूम राइट. तो स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम टू अब वॉल्यूम पर मास. ओके तो रेसिप्रोकल अब डेंसिटी उल्टा तो होगा ठीक है सर. ओके सो ऑल ऑफ यू गेट ऑल दिस प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फ्लूइड्स. Okay, so can we move on to next part? At least reply something, na? You guys can hear me or not? Okay, I'm moving on. So the next topic is thrust of liquid. So thrust and pressure are almost same. Only difference between them is thrust is upward force and pressure is a downward force. Okay, pressure and thrust is same, but pressure is downward force and thrust is upward force. So thrust is the total normal force exerted by liquid at rest at a given surface is called thrust of the liquid. So let us consider a bucket of water. If we throw a plastic bottle on the water, then it will float. Why? Because it the a force is acting on it upward. That force is called thrust. Okay, the SI unit of thrust is liquid. Sorry, not liquid. Newton. So SI unit of thrust is Newton. So we already know that fluid mechanics is the branch of science which determines the behavior of fluids. So there are two part of fluid mechanics. When fluid is in rest, that is hydrostatic. When fluid is in motion, that is hydrodynamics. Okay, next topic is fluid pressure.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Thrust mane ki Assamese is meaning to thrust or spelling to.
Thrust or Assamese spelling to kyo lage toma eto T H U R S T.
No, mane meaning to ma'am.
Meaning to mane so atu tumi ite jodi plastic or bottle ata pani pelai disa no hetu tu dub na jay no hetu tu upore upomi ahibo no. So the next topic is fluid pressure. So thrust is the upward force and pressure is the downward force. The normal force exerted by the fluid per unit area of the surface of contact is called the fluid pressure or hydrostatic pressure. So this is the formula for calculating the pressure of liquid, which is P equal to small p equal to h rho g. This is called rho. Rho is the density of the liquid and h is the height of the liquid column and g is acceleration due to gravity. We already know that. So write down the formula for calculating pressure. P equal to h rho g. So pressure can be caused by gravity, acceleration, forces on a closed container, etc. So pressure increases when we go deeper and pressure decreases when we go upper. So in the lower part of any fluid, the pressure is higher at the upper part of the any fluid the pressure is low, quite low. So for in the next class we will discuss Pascal's law from and up to this. If you have any question you can ask me, or otherwise I will start asking question, you have to answer. So jodi kiba buji pua na etia huda. No question. So can I ask you question now?
Electricity and hydrodynamic in hydrostatic and hydrodynamic.
Hydrostatics and hydrodynamics. So fluid mechanics se ki kore fluid or behavior upor study kore ha na hoy. So jodi rest of thaka fluid upor ami mane jitu pani tu boi thaka nai ba any gas jitu rest of ase hetu hol hydrostatic hetu branch of kom hydrostatic. And jodi the fluids are in motion তেতিয়া হলে বই থকা পানী বা এনি ফ্লো হৈ থকা লিকুইড গ্যাস এবিলাক যদি স্টাডি কৰো হেতু ব্রাঞ্চ অফ হাইড্রোডাইনামিক্স হাইড্রোডাইনামিক্স ওকে হোয়াই পিপল আর জয়নিং ইউ নাও দা ক্লাস ইজ অলমোস্ট ওভার না So no question now. What is the difference between liquid and gases? Again, can anyone tell me?
Liquids have definite volume and gases do not have.
Okay. So tell me the properties of liquids. Fluids properties of fluids. What are the properties of fluids?
Temperature, pressure.
Yes.
Specific volume.
Yes.
Density.
Yes.
Velocity. No, ma'am. Viscosity.
Yes.
Hello.
Oh yes.
Can you say me that?
Can I what? पूछो जल्दी क्या पूछना है?
मैम example of rest hydrostatic force.
Example of hydrostatic force. Force is not hydrostatic. The liquids who are at rest they are called hydrostatic. Okay, force is not hydrostatic. If liquids are at rest then the study of the liquids whose liquids or fluids whose at rest this is called hydrostatic. But when the fluids are in motion, if we study the fluids whose in motion, that part is called hydrodynamic. Okay. Okay, what are the three temperature scales?
Celsius, Kelvin,
yes, Fahrenheit.
Okay. What is the unit of density?
Volume. Mass by volume.
Yes, it is mass by volume. But what is the unit?
Kilogram per cubic meter.
Yes, yes. Kg per meter cube.
Kg per meter cube.
So, what is the difference between pressure and thrust?
Ma'am, pressure.
Yes.
Pressure is downward force and thrust is upward force.
Okay. ओके सो सब बुझि पाइसा बुझिस आरो नेक्स्ट पासा पास्कल फ्लो टु दे ओके आई विल एक्सप्लेन फ्रॉम पास्कल फ्लो इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास I suppose all of you have understood today's class. Okay,
yes, ma'am.
Your attendance one by one.76 present, 18 present, 19 present, then 50 present, 31, 62, 74, 68, roll number 10, 37, 70, 47, 13, 32, 38, 28, 6, 67, 72, 15, 6, 6 is already. Roll number 2, 60, 51, 12, 46, 75, 21, 35, 54, 44, 40, 18, 14, 56, 45, 4, 55, 75, 69, 19, 38, roll number 2, 12. Okay, anyone left? No one? Okay, thank you,
yes,
students.
Yes, yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. 50, 51.
51. Okay. Anyone else left? No. Okay. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.